All right, I'm going to be talking about a very common topic that I hear a lot. I see this in dog forums, I see this in Facebook pages or groups, and I get people messaging me about this on a constant basis, and it is dog training schools. I myself went to two different dog training schools. I love both of them a lot. I'm going to talk in general about dog training schools. There are a couple of things to keep in mind. One is, what kind of dog trainer do you want to be? What kind of dog trainer do you foresee yourself being the most fulfilled with, or that you feel most comfortable with? If you didn't know by now, there are three different schools of thought on dog training. There are the purely positive trainers. These are trainers that feel very comfortable with the idea of a reward-based system 100%, or at least 99% of the times. You've got your trainers that, they don't use food, they don't use markers as much. They use praise. There are out there. I'm not gonna mention any school specific, but there are schools out there that are like that. They use pressure and praise. That's it. I myself happen to subscribe to the other school of thought, which is balance trainers. Now, balance trainers, the proper methodology for balance trainers are, we do a lot of positive stuff, a lot of purely positive techniques, and we're very proficient in those techniques, but we also use other methods and other tools to ensure responsibility and discipline from the dog. So those are the your three basic areas of dog training. Now, if I feel most comfortable with a reward-based system, then I should probably look at reward-based type schools, schools that offer that type of curriculum. So that kind of narrows down your choice a little bit more. One thing you could do too, as far as dog training schools go, do your research. Definitely call the company, definitely call the school. Calling the school, though, you're going to hear good things about the school. They're not going to tell you all the negative things about the school. But it is good feedback. You can get a lot of questions answered. If you can talk to an instructor, talk to an instructor, and they can talk to you about the benefits of that school or what the curriculum is like. Another thing to keep in mind, one thing that you could do is talk to people who graduated from that school. I went to two different dog training schools, so I can give you feedback on those dog training schools. I'm not going to give you feedback on a school that I did not go to. I can tell you, hey, if you ask me about this particular school, I can tell you I never went to that school, but I work with people that went to that school, and I can tell you what they've told me. But even then, my information, my feedback is diluted. It's not accurate. So talk to graduates, people who actually graduated from the school, not people who got kicked out of the school. Not people that did not get to graduate, did not get to make to the end of the school. Talk to people who actually graduated. That is good information. With that, I want you to keep in mind there are three different kinds of graduates. With every dog training school, you're going to have three different kinds of customers, three different kinds of people that went to that school. You're going to have your cheerleaders. These are the dog trainers or the graduates that love the school 100%. They absolutely loved it. I myself, I'm one of them. Two dog training schools I went to, loved them, absolutely loved them. So I'm on that cheerleader part. Then you've got your disgruntled customers. These are the people that absolutely freaking hated the school. They hated everything about the school. They'll give you a list of everything negative. Like, not one thing positive, maybe one or two things positive that are more on the ironic part. Still good feedback, though. And there are your graduates that are in the middle, the people that saw the benefits of the school, but they also acknowledge the downfalls of the school. They actually acknowledge the good and the bad. Those are the people that I love to talk to because they give me a more fair description of the school. They give me a better picture of what that school is about. Talking to the cheerleaders, that's great. Talking to the disgruntled customers, that's great. But do not base your decisions 100% on those people. If you talk to like two, three cheerleaders, that's great. But there are things that are, you know, things that could be improved on in every single school, every single company. So talk to other people. Now, if you only talk to the disgruntled customers, you're only going to hear the negative things. So be careful with that as well. Talk to the people that are somewhere in the middle, the people that can give you, you know, the black and the white of that. Now, if the one school has way too many disgruntled customers, you have to be careful with that. That just means that maybe there is something wrong with the school. If I talk to a handful of graduates and they've all had terrible experiences, that tells me something. That tells me the odds of me having a good time at that school, probably not good. So you should be able to find people in all those three areas. Another thing to keep in mind with dog training schools is budget. A good dog training school is not going to last, you know, a week or 5 days. That's more of a workshop, which they are out there and they're very valuable too. But a dog training school, a full immersion dog training school, will last you anywhere from 4 weeks to 3 months and even more. These are your full immersion type dog training schools. And they don't come cheap. This is something that you're more than likely going to have to get a loan for. And that's kind of how it is. Some dog training schools, if you are a veteran, they will work with you because they take the GI Bill. And the last thing that I want to talk about in regards to dog training schools is you have to realize dog training schools will not make you successful. That's not what it is. A dog training school will not ensure your success as a dog trainer, as a business person at all. Okay, you need to decide that you're going to be successful way before you show up to that dog training school. And it starts there and it lasts till the end of your career. If you expect the dog training school to make you this amazing dog trainer by the end of that course, you're sadly, sadly mistaken. I deal with dog training students on a regular basis. I've been at this school for like 3 years now, going on four. And every single class, we get students that do great, they do amazing. And then we have students that don't do very well. Now, everybody learns at their own speed and all, but we have students that have a great attitude and we got students that have a terrible attitude. And that is all on you. Dog training school is not gonna hold your hand. A dog training school is not gonna magically, with a piece of paper and a signature, make you successful. You have to put in the work.